Alright guys, welcome back to more Red Dead Redemption 2. Mr. Ring Pants here. Don't get mad, bro. Get angry. Hope you're enjoying my first person free game walkthrough. And I almost got my horse's head smashed in. Oh. I'm gonna get off right here before I hit somebody. We're gonna talk to Chironi and then Dutch.
If you want to fit in so well, no one realizes you're there to rob the place. Now, come on.
What are you talking about?
That suit is not fit for the purpose at hand. Come along, dear boy. Come along.
Hello. Can I help you, gentlemen?
Yes. My friend here is in need of a new suit. We are playing on the riverboat this evening.
Excellent. Well, you'll find all my inventory in the catalog here.
Make this gentleman look like the Duke he really is. It was the English's fault his grandfather had to emigrate. You can see the aristocrat in his profile. The heavy brow from all the...
That's all I can get.
I suggest the fine three-piece town suit, sir. Perfect for the occasion, I'd say.
If I can only get
something of a hurry here, Arthur.
Fine, three-piece town suit.
Chop chop. Let's get you out of that cattle there and into something easy.
A very good choice, sir.
Well, I mean, it was free. The barber. Man, I've been trying to grow my hair out.
Scope the whole thing out. It's quite ingenious, actually.
What is?
The action he has planned. Indeed, it's not much of an action at all. You play cards and win. And you're going to bet very big and flamboyantly while you win. And everyone's going to think you're some new money from the oil fields come to lay it on thick and drunk. All the while, Herr Strauss will be signaling you in your line of sight. When you bust the place, they'll take you upstairs to pay you off. And that is when Javier comes in, and you take whatever you want.
You don't think they might see an armed Mexican coming into the safe with me?
Sure, they might, but perhaps not. You will see.
The suspense is killing me.
Don't be so jaded. We both know this is just the kind of innocent fun you thrive on.
Well, after the past couple of months, armed robbery don't seem such an innocent pastime.
No, but we, you, all of us, will be done here soon.
I hope so.
Come on.
Well, if I'm gonna get dressed up fancy, then I guess he's the best person to help me with it, huh?
My good man, could you smarten up my dear hick friend here?
Man.
This unlikely fellow has made himself a fortune in the oil fields and learned himself not a lick of manners or gentlemanly deportment.
Very good, sir.
No, it's not good. Not good at all. Not if they're going to let him play big at the tables tonight.
There, very smart.
Come on, let's get to the docks. I've arranged some transportation.
Well, I want my hat. Why'd that say extra? Oh, enter.
Keeping a gentleman waiting. I don't know. George, to the Grand Corrigan, please.
Grand Corrigan, sir.
Well, look at you.
bit much, ain't it? The coach?
We can't whinny up there on horses like a bunch of countrified yokels. You're a brash oil man. Money to buy. Which reminds me, no shuffling and mumbling. Puff your chest out. Get outside yourself.
Yeah, all right, all right. This ain't happening. So, who's a mark?
Is he all right, by the way, the driver?
Oh, yes, don't worry. George and I go way back. It's a man called Desmond Blythe. Made a fortune in hosiery, of all things. Likes to play fast and always keep some extra collateral in the safe upstairs.
So, if Strauss is sitting behind him, how does he know what cards I got?
He won't. But the dealer has recently become a very good friend of mine.
Another one.
Don't worry, Arthur. We're all the authors of our own good fortune. He'll make sure you get the right cards.
What could possibly go wrong?
Indeed.
And what money am I playing with?
Don't worry. That has all been arranged. Your chips will be waiting. Ah, there she is. Come on.
Okay.
Arthur, leave any weaponry here. There are searches when we get on. George, we'll collect these from you later.
Very good, sir.
Thank you, George.
Good luck, sir.
Now remember what I said, Arthur. Everyone is the author of his own good fortune.
Yes, yes, believe me, I heard every word.
Watch Strauss, listen to the dealer, and this should be a very lucky night.
Watch Strauss, listen to the dealer. Those two look familiar.
Drinks on Arthur. Champagne.
Lanchester.
Champagne. All around.
I'm afraid we require all patrons to hand over their guns.
Good time. The tables await.
I'll go find myself a change of clothes.
Okay.
You seem unsure.
Robbing a heavily armed riverboat without a gun tends to bring out the self-doubt in me.
People are virtually idiots. This is simple stuff. Now have a good time, but don't lose too much money or your wife is going to kill me.
Whatever you say.
Now where can I get a cocktail?
Alright, so Strauss knows his hands will be dead. They'll follow his instructions. I'm gonna mess up.
Welcome to the game, Mr. Callahan. Okay, gentlemen, let's play.
Hope you're a player. Been too many cowards at these tables recently. Nothing less dignified than a man afraid to lose a little money.
Look at this! Chips already stacked up, waiting for me. I like this joint already.
We aim to please, sir.
So, how are we all faring?
Some better than others.
If we all fared the same in life now, where would the fun be?
Quiet.
Wait, not Desmond Blythe, the hosiery king. I should have brought my other wallet.
Not my preferred title, but yes, you should have.
So 19, right?
Call, what the hell?
$14, $28, I'll just bet everything.
Here goes nothing.
Here we go then.
Okay, sorry boys, I'm taking it all.
We'll see about that.
To hell with it.
Well, hello, my ladies.
Mr. Blythe wins with three queens.
Really?
Goodbye, gentlemen. I guess it's just you and me now, friend.
Yes, it is.
Time to see if you're really the man you seem to think you are.
Likewise, Mr. Blythe.
So, what business are you in, Mr. Callahan?
I'm an oil man, for my sins.
Funny. I haven't heard of you.
Oh, you will. You know, I thought about getting into hosiery, but I just look better in a suit.
I would stick to oil, Mr. Callahan. I don't think you have a future on the stage.
You sound just like my wife.
Trying to figure out what, I must mean he's stubbing his bat. All in.
Now what the hell? It's only money. Interesting.
Ooh.
They're cowgirls.
Shit. Shit.
I guess my luck held. Is that you done?
Done.
Bust. Or, you got something else to play with.
Meaning?
Well, I heard there were some big boys on this boat. Maybe that's not you. No offense.
Sit your hillbilly ass down.
Why?
I got a watch.
Look at you.
An expensive one. Real fine. Swiss. A Reutlinger, no less. It's in the safe upstairs. It's worth more than you.
Okay. I trust you.
Now play.
As you wish.
So, you must know Leviticus Cornwall, big oil man like you.
Of course, we've crossed paths. I was fortunate enough to tour a little operation of his up in New Hanover.
I am 100% all in, Mr. Callahan.
Don't worry, sir. Everyone is the author of his own good fortune.
All in.
Well, nothing ventured, nothing gained. Pear kings.
Very good, but not good enough.
Shit. Uh-oh. Yes, you little beauty.
Hard lines, Mr. Blythe. Mr. Callahan wins with an ace-high diamond flush.
God damn you!
No offense.
None taken.
Well played, sir.
Unlucky, Desmond.
Now, forgive my lack of discretion, but, where might I find this watch?
It's upstairs. Shall we go and have a look?
Why not?
Gentlemen.
Please, cash these out for me.
I started last week.
Good. Sure. Perhaps you could escort us up to the office.
Oh, hello, Jose.
Yes,
sir. Thank you.
Follow me, gentlemen.
Or Javier. Call him Hosea.
Having quite the night.
Yeah, so far.
I cannot believe someone gave a greaser a job.
We live in strange times.
Personally, I wouldn't trust one with a gun, but fear not. I've got my own little lawgiver right here.
Very good.
Next. We'll be hiring Negroes.
Yeah, I know.
Thought we weren't allowed to have guns.
I like this watch, sir. I saw it earlier, and it really is a handsome piece. Foreign made,
indeed.
Well, here we are.
Something bad is going to happen when I walk in here.
Just give me 1 second, sir.
Of course, take your time.
Disarm.
I guess you were right. Only an idiot would give a greaser a gun.
Taking it off. Well, this is where everything goes downhill. You don't currently have your gun belt or satchel.
If we're lucky.
Is that a gunshot? It sounded like one. Come on.
And how exactly are we getting out of here?
I ain't too sure. This is what tends to happen when you leave Trelawney in charge of planning. Oh, garnish no meat. Probably involve us dressing up as dancing girls and can-canning off the side. Nice uniform, by the way.
Thanks. Give anyone a job these days. Anyway, we shouldn't give ourselves away till we know we need to. Maybe we could still blend into the crowd when it all goes crazy.
Which it surely will. To the bar, senor!
I hope you had fun, sir.
The time of my life. You boys sure know how to put on a show.
That's wonderful. Ah, look, there's your friend.
Tough and no good, Chief, and I beg you to take back the insinuation.
There he is.
Now, don't be a sore loser, friend.
There's something I don't like about the pair of you.
There's plenty I don't like about you, but I have the good manners to keep my mouth shut.
There he is. Shoot that man.
Oh. Come on,
Arthur. We
gotta get out of here. Who are we shooting at? Boom. This one's different. This one has slower. It must not be in good condition. I feel bad for that character. He just like walks in not knowing what's going on.
What are we supposed to do now, huh?
Come on. Shooting you all. I like this Lancer without the scope on it. I wonder if this is the ferry in the first Red Dead. There's a floating bottle. Oh, shoot. Alright. And away we go.
Well, never a dull moment.
Yeah, that's one way of putting it.
So, how much did we get?
A few thousand, I think. Pretty good.
Yes, indeed.
And this watch. Apparently it's worth a bunch. Swiss, a Reutlinger or something.
Nice watch. Yes, it's
It's a right lingo, all right.
We'll give it back then. All right, come on, let's get out of here.
I'd be lying if I didn't say I thought there was going to be a bigger shootout. Something like the, what we did at the house camp stuff. Like, I expected us to, like, maybe get on another boat and then, have to, like, have a bunch of other boats after us and try to get away and such. But no. So I'll pick it up when we get over here to Dutch, and I'll try to get that in here as well. Alright, so now guys, we're over here near Dutch. I'm gonna get this in the video, hopefully, we'll see. This may or may not be a different video, I don't know yet.
City boy, what's the urgency?
We need to leave forever.
We've been doing well, making money, but for us all to leave together, we need enough for a boat. Now, I found a friendly ship captain. He's willing to take us to Australia or Tahiti. We just need to pay for passage and give him money for land when we get there. No questions asked. We will disappear, be reborn.
Well, where the hell is Tahiti?
South Pacific, an untouched paradise.
Who lives there?
Tahitians, I guess.
We made a bit of money on that riverboat job, but not enough for us to leave and live peacefully. Where's the rest coming from?
In there.
So we are gonna rob that place.
Well, I didn't think we was fixing the plumbing. I don't know if you have noticed, but we are on the clock. I reckon we got a few days before the Pinkerton show, and then, well, we're done. Now, we need money. Bronte said this place has got Come on.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is a robbery. Behave as I tell you, and none of you will die. Annoy me, and you all will. Now remember, we just want money. Don't make us kill you. Mr. F.
You need to give me all your money now.
Mr. F, check that room back there. I got this one. Dying.
Well, that's dumb. They shouldn't take my honor away.
Open that gate and let my acquaintance inside.
Come on. These folks must have some
moment. My acquaintance.
Of course. Not very nice.
All your money now. Don't make me ask twice.
Of course. Just take it.
There's nothing much here.
What?
There's nothing really here.
You're sure?
Yes.
Then get out here and get ready for company. All of you. Behave. We don't want to hurt any of you. Mr. M, check the safe.
Sure.
All right. Check the safe. Safe. Where's the safe?
Open it.
Oh.
I don't think they keep much cash in there.
Open it. Nothing here.
There should be stacks of cash in there. He told us there was. Look again.
There's no stacks. A few dollars in coins. That's it.
Damn! We got a problem. There's a ton of cops out there.
Fire now! We got you surrounded!
That greasy son of a bitch! He set us up!
You think?
This seemed like a good time for sarcasm to you, Arthur.
What are we gonna do, gentlemen?
Something. The trolley. The trolley! Follow me, gentlemen! Now.
Does this trolley go to Tahiti?
I hope so.
Oh, I got unlimited ammo. Wait. Soft sides. Hoo-hoo! Got you. Yeah, don't gotta worry about no ammo capacity. Well, shite. I'm gonna use a semi-automatic pistol. Not even hitting the son of a gun. Where is he? Oh, there he is. Ooh, right in the face. Oh man, oh man. Where's the other dude? There he is. Good thing for Deadeye. Okay, okay, we're... kind of hard to see him over there. There we go. Got him. Maybe not. Dang, I only got 28 bullets left. Shoot. Oh, shakalaka. Alright, where are we moving to? Okay, we're moving upwards. Haha, I don't know if I got him. Do that. Give me my dead eye. Woohoo! Go, 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 go. Man, this thing shoots fast and dead eye. I got 4 bullets left for this. Might as well use it up on him. Wait, how did I get another 150? And ooh, right to the face. That's slow motion, I tell you. Hiya! Really? And do that. Hiya! Oh. I'll take that. Okay, now I gotta worry about just using one type of gun. Ooh. Point blank range in the head. I'm gonna pick up your hat if you don't mind. Thank you. And headshot, headshot. Booga 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 yaka laka die. They all have like double barrel shotguns. Or like when I slow motion kill them, they're like got double barrel. Huh. Alright, who's coming from where? Ooh, almost didn't get that one. Ooh, I think I got him like in the nose and the mouth. Okay, okay, who's next? And man, that slow motion, I tell ya. Where? We're on the left. Alright, well, they're not chasing after us. And we'll do that again. Man, it gets hard to aim, like, even with Deadeye. Like, it's, like, slower, like, to move your curse, the arrow to, the dot to shoot. Really? Oh! Wait, where is it? I didn't really like the fact that I lost armor.
You know what, Dutch? Next time, let's not damn discretion.
Seemed like a good lead.
I know, but...
Well, we made it. Thanks to you.
Don't mention it.
Yeah.
You're a good kid.
And we each got $15. Oh, and a quarter. Don't forget the quarter.
Shut up, Arthur. He set us up. Played me like a yokel. Put the law on us. What do we do to him?
What did I do to him? I guess he thinks he's the king around here. He don't want the likes of you. So, what are we doing next, Dutch?
We just need... One more decent take, and we're gone.
bet. Hosea agrees.
Even after that?
Especially after that. I don't feel so good.
Now you just got a bash on the head.
Come on. I'm taking you back to camp.
Hey, you did real good there, Lenny. Just wish it could have turned out better.
Well, you can't win them all.
Alright then. So that is that. That's probably gonna be the end of the video if I put the ferry mission in here, robbery, which I probably will. And it looks like we have to do this, and then unless I load back in and there's something more. I wonder why we didn't rob the Rhodes Bank. That's what I was, because we did the Valentine Bank. Rhodes has a pretty big bank. I don't get why we don't rob the Rhodes Bank and then rob Saint Denis. That would be, and I don't know. I don't think Van Horn has a bank. But all right, well, thank you guys for watching. We'll see you in the next video.